If you are someone who is looking to learn a subject which is very tough, but you wanted to make it much more easier, hello and welcome to Planet. This video is about how to learn a difficult subject or a difficult topic in a very easy and understandable way. So here is my planner. Let me explain you. So here in my planner, I drew few boxes. You might be wondering what it is. So this is called a topic planner. So whatever the subject you are reading, you can choose, you can make this topic planner accordingly. So for example, this is the page. I made it for one topic. So here on the top, you write down the title of the topic, and in the next you have the duration. So I keep a time. So it can be hours or days or weeks. So the next one is the action plan and the tasks. So action plan is you divide this section with the subtopics. I mean, if you are reading a big topic or a chapter, there would be some smaller topics in it. So you break down all those into the action plan. Once you finish writing your subtopics or the topics to read, then you move on to the tasks. For example, to learn this complete topic, what are the tasks that you need to do? First, you read and you also revise the topic, or you need to do some tests, or you need to practice, or whatever. That comes under the tasks. So action plan is nothing but you divide the topic into the smaller topics. I mean the subtopics. In this section, you write down the materials that you collect for your topic. This is mainly the topic planner. You can use this to study a particular topic or a chapter. So you can do this for each and every topic or for each and every chapter. So if you follow this type of topic planners for your subject, here you're allotting time for your subjects. So as I have taken 3 days, so I have planning for 3 days. It depends upon you. It can be 1 day, 2 days, or a week. It depends upon the topic. So basic idea of this page is you are allotting time for the topics that you need to read. Don't worry, I will explain you how to use this planner effectively. So here is another page which is most important part of this learning. Here you are going to write about the same, you write the titles and all the stuff, but this is the summary planner of your topic. Now it's time to learn how to use this planner. Here we are going to write the title of the topic or whatever the topic that we wanted to learn. You write it down here. So for this, so here we write down the duration. It depends upon the topic that you choose. For example, for so and so topic, I just took 3 days. So within 3 days, I need to finish this topic or learn this topic. So I just kept 3 days duration. If it is in an hour, you can also place in 1 hour, or it can be 1 day or 1 week, whatever it is. So I'm just telling you about the smaller topics. So then you write down you divide it into two sections. One is action plan or tasks, or you can have one column for this. Here in this action plan, it can be learning the first step in learning any topic is you have to learn the basics. So make sure whatever the topic you're studying, you learn about the basics. Then move on to the smaller topics. I mean, you break down the topic into the smaller portions. So you can list down all those topics. For example, in a heading, there would be three topics, three smaller topics. So you can list down those three topics, or else you can, in this action plan, you can mark days. So on day one, you can read certain topics. On day two, you can do certain topics. So you can also make this plan, or you can also make this plan. So I just mentioned both in one column. Not necessarily you need to make both, but you can make, you can write down only the topics, or you can write down only the, I mean, breaking down into the days, and then here you write down the topics that you need to read on so and so date. So coming to the tasks, so for reading, here you need to learn or understand the subject. So for that you need to do certain tasks. So for example, reading one, or reading, or self-assessment tasks, taking test, or practicing. So practicing is the better way to understand a subject, whether you have understood it or not. So that's it. So you break down all these topics into the tasks. For example, if you are doing maths, for that you need to practice well. For example, if you are doing computers, that also you need to practice it well. So writing down those topics that has to be practiced, or rereading, so you can break down that small topics into your smaller tasks. And next comes the materials. Here in the materials part, you might be having textbooks. If you are in the school, you would be having textbooks. If you are going to the college, you would be referring to so many books. So nowadays kids also uses online to learn subjects. So here you can write down the websites where you can find out the information, or you can write down the books or the page numbers where you have learned about that topic, or if you are a college student, you can write down the journal. So this is optional. This is for the college kids, and for the school, this is enough. So that's it. Then I just wanted to show you, if the space is not enough here, I mean, if you wanted to read so many topics and you wanted to actually divide it into, have a larger picture, then you can have this plan, or else this is enough. You can plan here. If you have so many things to write down or break down your topics, then you can plan this. So this is, so here I have divided it into day 1, day 2 and day 3. So for example, I have day 1 I plan to read, and for the day 2 is I need to reread or reevaluate whatever it is. So on day 3 is I only do the self-assessment things, or if there are any topics that I need to cover, so on this day. So this is how I have divided into 3 days. So on day 1, I have you need to list out all the subtopics here. So this subtopics is something that I have mentioned here. So you can write down all the topics, and then you can just once you study, then you can strike it out. Then you would be definitely having an idea what you have read. And on day 2, you would recollect all the information. Basically, this is like practicing what you have read, or remembering, or whatever it is. So on this day, you practice or read all the subtopics that have been done. So this would be your second read. On the third day, so you can have a self-assessment. You can also do it on the same day if you have, but it is good to do it the next day or the next 2 days, so that you would know how well you remember the topic. So here on day 3, you can make a topic summary sheet. You can check what all you have learned, like mind mapping or whatever it is. Once you have done your test, you can make this making a topic of summary sheet. So this summary sheet I showed here. So this summary sheet is like this. The topic again. So you're writing down all your topics here, and when you write down all the subtopics also, you would automatically remind in your mind. So here you write down the title of the topic here and the main idea. What is this topic about? Why is this, or anything related to that topic, the main important topic. And here are the details. So you can list out all the important points related to this topic, and it can be in small bullet points. Depending upon the topic, you divide these sections. So I have given three boxes for these important points, and then the summary. So you write down the summary about the topic that you have learned. This is very important, because this would help you remember what you have learned, and also this page would definitely help you in future, as this has allowed you to recollect all the information that you have learned. And in future, that is before your exams, you can just go ahead this page. If you have time, you can just go ahead and read, which is good sometimes in the last minute. So this type of pages would definitely help you. So for each and every topic, if you start making this type of pages for every topic or for every lesson which you feel difficult, or whatever it is, even if it is not difficult, you can make it. So once it is done, you can store all these particular topics related to one subject in one file. And at the end of the course, in person, I use this idea to learn the topics or any subject that is difficult for me. I'll make sure it has to be easy. So I'm sharing this with you. Hope you like it. I know this video is a little lengthy, but I could not edit much, with the intention to convey what I wanted to say. I'm also on Instagram, on Planet. Do follow me and stay tuned for Planet. Bye bye, and see you in the next video.